Thank you. You may be seated. Good evening, and welcome to the commencement exercises of the 2022-23 graduating class of East Hollywood High School. I am Katrina Walker, principal of East Hollywood High School. And I welcome friends, family members, administration, faculty and staff, members of the Board of Trustees, and I welcome the graduating students of East Hollywood High School, class of 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to announce tonight that we have 91 students who are graduating from East Hollywood High School. As you look at their names on our program, you will see abbreviations following some of their names. These abbreviations signify honors, early graduates, valedictorian, salutatorian, and so forth. I would like to announce that the valedictorian at East Hollywood High School this year is Serena Zipsky. And our salutatorian at East Hollywood High School this year is Declan Evergreen. Please, Serena, Declan, please stand. Please recognize our 2023 valedictorian and salutatorian. Thank you. East Hollywood High School partners with Snow College to provide the opportunity for students to earn college credit while they are still in high school. I would like to acknowledge the following students who are graduating with college credit. Please stand as I read your name. Cyan Fenton, Taylor Marshall, Foliaka Ofa, Serena Zemsky. I would also like to recognize students who are graduating with honors, having a grade point average of 3.5 or higher. Please stand as I read your name. Paige Grant, Declan Evergreen, Taylor Marshall, Serena Zemsky. Graduating students, there isn't a single one of you who got to this point in your life without the support of others. There are people in your lives, parents, grandparents, other family members, friends, who have encouraged you, pushed you, maybe even threatened you. I would like to acknowledge the contributions of friends and family members of this year's graduating class, and I say to each of you, thank you for all you have done in their lives. Graduates, be sure that you thank these wonderful people who are here supporting you tonight for their encouragement and for their help. I wish at this time also to acknowledge the faculty and staff at East Hollywood High School. I am honored to have the privilege to work with this amazing staff. I am honored that they have chosen East Hollywood as the school that they dedicate their lives to. They are dedicated and passionate. They are an inspiration to me and their students. They have worked extremely hard in providing an education to support to you students. They care about each and every one of you. Also included is Ryan Marchant, my co-director and business manager. He works tirelessly to manage the business and financial side of our school. Please make sure you let these wonderful people who have given you so much know how grateful you are. I would also like to acknowledge the school's Board of Trustees. The Board of Trustees is the governing body of the school, and we appreciate the very important voluntary service of these board members. Skip Francone, our board president, Dr. Richard West, Susan Soleil, Scott Pruitt, Amanda Darrow, Nicole Lowe McBride, and Cody McBride. Please join me in expressing appreciation to all the members of East Hollywood High School Board of Trustees. Thank you. Graduating class of 2023, tonight is all about you. You have faced and overcome many challenges to get to this day, and I acknowledge all of your hard work, persistence, and dedication, and I commend you for qualifying yourselves for this important milestone in your lives. We are proud of you and are very happy to celebrate your accomplishments tonight. Most importantly, you must be proud of yourself. Over the past 4 years, you have been working to gain credit in all the right classes, You've taken math, language arts, science, film, and many other classes in which you learned the skills to prepare you for your futures. But the lessons that will carry you the farthest did not come from the textbooks. The most important lessons are the life lessons you have learned from your experiences. Yesterday, I asked each of you to write about your experiences at East Hollywood High School, and I'd like to share some of those. Jenica Jones said, "East Hollywood completely changed my life. This school showed me a level of acceptance I had never experienced in my life. I was accepted with open arms by my peers and teachers. I was given life-changing opportunities and experience that inspired my passions. I felt comfortable and safe expressing myself, and I knew I always had support in my corner." Kylie Robles wrote, "I was scared to come to school. I could never step into a school. But when I came to East Hollywood, they let me in with open arms and made me feel like I could do anything and everything." Katie Baxter wrote, "This school made me feel more welcome than any other place I have been." Zan Chandler wrote, "This school has given me a space to fully express myself and be confident with who I am." Finley Hodges said, "I learned to be myself." And Shiloh DeGraff also said, "East Hollywood helped me discover who I am." Many of you wrote about how East Hollywood felt like home. This is a feeling that you can take with you. The Code of the Man Bear states, respect yourself, those around you, and the school. At East Hollywood, you have learned to honor diversity in others and to be true to yourself. Take that man bear spirit of acceptance and respect with you, and you will make the world more beautiful. My favorite rule in the Man Bear Code is no excuses, play like a champion. Another word for this is perseverance. At East Hollywood, we ask you to face your challenges bravely and never back down, never making excuses. None of you made it to this day easily. All of you had challenges along the way. And as tough as things have been, you have proven that you are tougher. I have seen in you the power, the intellect, and the courage to accomplish whatever you set your mind to. You have learned to face hardships head on and conquer them. You have learned that the power is in you to accomplish great things, far greater than the accomplishments we are celebrating tonight. You will make mistakes, but know that you are never a mistake. Pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and move forward. It will take hard work, dedication, courage, patience, sweat, tears, determination, but you have already proven that you can persevere. No matter what comes your way, you are equal to the task. You are destined for greatness. You are champions. Tonight, you look back with pride on your achievements as you now begin to look forward with hope to the future. Thank you and congratulations. And good luck to each of you. The balance of our ceremony will follow as outlined in our program. We'll now hear from our commencement speaker, Jonathan Morales.
Oh boy. First of all, I want to say thank you to all the teachers, parents, guardians, friends, and family who have showed up today. And today I wanted to talk about how East Hollywood has changed me and inspired me. Now, I got to say, I've not been the best student in the 4 years. I've definitely decided not to go to school just to sleep. But I've learned a lot throughout these 4 years. One thing I learned that was super important to me was the power of confidence within ourselves. Sometimes we feel like we can't reach our goals or our promises that we make to ourselves. That's not true, because I've seen it within all of you, all my graduates. I know you all have amazing talent and abilities you can use. And you guys have taught me some of those skills as well as to my teachers. They have taught me so many skills I would know, and I would like to thank them right now. I would like to thank all my teachers, but I'm gonna talk about a certain few. I want to say thank you, Annie, for teaching me that I should be myself and not what others want me to be. Allowing myself to be confident and proud of myself. Thank you, Taylor, for teaching me to push myself to my limits that I place upon myself. And allowing me to show my true strength. And thank you, Thomas, for being so awesome, but really being honest with us, not allowing me to force a way, and I should have my own opinions. Thank you. I want to say thank you to Will, Spencer, and Cohen. For teaching me such amazing skills, such as filmmaking, cinematography, and photography skills. I'm sure I'll use them in the future. Thank you. And of course, I want to thank my staff, Nolan, Katrina, Haley, Krista, Margie, Gary, and Amanda. Thank you for being so amazing. And now I want to thank the people who have taught me the most at East Hollywood, and that's definitely the students. Now, they have taught me a lot of things, but the most important things they have taught me is patience, respect for one another, no matter how different we are, teamwork and leadership skills, and being able to communicate and socialize with each other better. Thank you for teaching me so much. Now we're about to leave and enter the real world, as we say. Now, I'm not sure how all of us are gonna turn out, and for a lot of us, it's gonna be tough. It doesn't matter, because I know all of you have potential. We're gonna have ups and downs, but in the end, I'm sure you're gonna do great. Now I'm gonna make a selfish moment for myself and say that I know that I'm not the best person, but I know I can do great in the future. And if anyone in my family's recording, then thank God, because I know I can do it. I doubted myself so much, and I thought I'd even be on this stage right now, but here I am, and I can do well. Thank you for your time and listening. That's all I have to say, 2023.
So this is a song that's really important to me and really comforting to me in a world where everything's moving so fast and where you think that you have to have it all figured out. This song just helps remind me and hopefully the rest of the class of 2023 that you don't have to have it all figured out and that you got time. This is Vienna by Billy Joel. Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, well, tell me, why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You've got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. And will you realize Vienna waits for you? Slow down, you're doing fine. You can't be everything you want to be before your time. Although it's so romantic on the borderline tonight. Too bad. the life you lead, you're so ahead of yourself that you forgot what you need. Though you can see when you're wrong, you know you can't always see when you're right. You're right. You got your passion, you got your pride, but don't you know that only fools are satisfied? Dream on, but don't imagine they'll all come true. When will you realize piano waits for you? Crazy child, and take the phone off the hook and disappear for a while. It's all right, you can't afford to lose a day or two. Ooh, and will you realize piano waits for you? And you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Why don't you realize piano waits for you? When will you realize piano waits for you?
Good afternoon, Man Bears and family. Some of you know me as Serena, but a majority of you know me as Faye. I would like to take you guys on a little journey. People who knew me as a kid can say I was full of energy, super social, and had no fear of what others thought of me. Despite that, and being on good terms with most people, I didn't have many true friends, maybe two or three. So most of my free time at school would be spent talking to my teachers or working on projects in their class, or talking to the recess duties because oftentimes I didn't have somebody to play with. I'm so lucky for the staff in my elementary school. They truly inspired me and are also the reason I am most likely going to elementary teaching myself. They motivated me and cheered me on when not many would, and it's still something that sticks me to this day. As the years went on and I went on to middle school, the loneliness grew and I didn't feel like I belonged anywhere. I thought I was too weird or cringe or annoying, and that resulted in me in giving up on finding out who I was and finding comfort in conformity. There was not a lot of individuality, or at least without judgment, at my middle school, and that resulted in me holding myself back so I could get by in school without being judged for who I was. The summer of 2019, before my freshman year, was a rough one. I went through some tough things, and it really changed my perception of life. It honestly made the idea of a brand new high school without anyone I knew absolutely terrifying. But I also saw it as a new beginning. I had so much to learn, and little did I know how much these 4 years would change my life forever. I was met with a whole new set of challenges I've never faced before. Identity issues, loss of close friends, social pressure, drama, the whole thing. But as much as these things sucked, they were lessons, and in the end, they led me to where I am today. Despite all that, East Hollywood gave me the opportunity to find myself. Decided to go to East, and seeing people express themselves in ways I haven't seen before, and being loved for it is absolutely amazing to me. It wasn't something I've seen widely accepted at schools before. These past 4 years have been life-changing. I felt like I finally had the freedom to experiment with who I was without typical high school judgment. I explored my identity, my style, and grew as a person because I finally felt like I had opportunity to try new things.
Now, 4 years later, with a lot of trial and error, I feel like I finally know myself and, for the most part, know what I want to do. And I have East Hollywood and the people I met there to thank. Even though I went through some heavy struggles the past few years and made quite a few mistakes, in the long run, the school saved me and helped me grow and change from a young, naive people pleaser into a motivated adult who's learning that I don't need validation from others to love myself. Finally, finding friends that truly cared about me in a school where I didn't feel like a complete outcast was everything to me. I want to thank my friends for being by my side, and for the people I've had conflicts with, I still thank them for being a lesson to me and for still making some great memories. East Hollywood also gave me opportunities I never thought I would get, filmmaking and performing. Music is a language that speaks to me, and I've always had a love for music and concerts as long as I could remember. I always wanted to have a chance to perform one day, and now I've performed for Concert Production 3 years in a row, and it's been an honor. Thank you so much, Nick Foster, for being such an inspirational teacher. You always made class exciting, and you always had faith in me even when I doubted myself musically. I got to check off a couple things off the bucket list thanks to your classes. I spent a lot of my childhood watching movies with my dad. So my love for film began pretty early. My first experience on a set was as an extra on Graduation Sucks in summer 2020. And I absolutely fell in love and continued to work on projects for the next 3 years. Through film, I learned a lot of life lessons and met some amazing people and been opened up to so many new opportunities. Spencer Holt and Will McAllister have been absolutely amazing mentors, and I'm so grateful for the many classes I had with them and the lessons that they taught me. Thank you to all the teachers for all that they've done for me over the years and continuing to cheer me on and motivate me to be the best that I can be. The teachers at EHHS are unmatched to any others I've seen, and I truly don't think I would be here today giving this speech if it weren't for the teachers truly caring about me. During my time at EHHS, I've had many friends and acquaintances. There's one who stands out to me and has been there with me through literally everything. It's my best friend, Jenica Jones. She helped me so much with growing as a person and communicating well as always being there for me whenever I was having a hard time. We have been through so much, but we have the comfort knowing we will always have each other in the end. I truly don't think I would be where I am or nearly as mature and happy if it weren't for her and her guidance. She's like a sister to me. Thank you to the Jones family for welcoming me with open arms. Can't wait to make more memories with you guys. I love you all so much. I want to also give thanks to my parents for always being there for me. They helped pick me up when I struggled, encouraged me to figure out who I was, and gave me the freedom to express myself. I'll always appreciate that I have such supportive parents who want to embrace my true self. I love you guys so, so much. Leaving high school and entering life as an adult is bittersweet, exciting, scary, freeing. There are so many different emotions to process. There's a whole new world open to us now, and although it's intimidating, I really do think we'll be okay. I'm so proud of every one of you to making it to today. I know it's been a crazy past few years, but we all persevered and overcame our obstacles to walk this stage today. I can't wait to see where all your lives take you. I know y'all are gonna do some amazing things. We aren't at the end of our story yet. We're just on to the next chapter. As I enter the next chapter of my life, I can proudly say I finally know who I am and I am ready to take on the world with the people I love most. As Taylor Swift said, long story short, I survived. That's a wrap, East Hollywood. Now on to the future.
I am so proud of every single one of you, every single one of you. And I'm really excited to introduce to you today a keynote speaker who hails from East Hollywood. So I've got a few words here. I'm gonna introduce our speaker and you guys are in for a treat. Kirby Thomas Saxton was born December 13th in the year 1997. The first time he realized that films and movies were his passion and dream was when he was the ripe old age of 2 and he saw Toy Story 2 in the movie theater in 1999. Ever since then, Kirby has been passionate about film. He has other interests. He loves to write. He loves creating and appreciating art in any form. And he loves theater. He went to East Hollywood starting in the year 2012. And his favorite class that he had at EHHS was film history with me, which is pretty cool. I started at East Hollywood in 2012 as well, and I taught that film history class my very first term there. After high school, Kirby went to Columbia College in Chicago for a year. And then he got his associate's degree from Salt Lake Community College, and he recently received his Bachelor of Arts in Film and Media at the U of U. He is now getting ready to go to Chapman University in California this fall for a master's degree in screenwriting. Kirby has made over 50 short films, and when he was only 19 years old, so not much older than you guys, he started work on his first feature-length movie, which he completed when he was 21. The movie is 801, really good. You should check it out, it's on YouTube. And most recently, Kirby has completed a web series called Four Kings, which I had the pleasure of being a part of. And it was really fun because 10 years ago when I met Kirby, I got to work on projects and he was somebody I was able to direct in films. And now we've become friends and he hired me to act in a film he directed. It was a really special experience. I'm excited to see where you guys are going to be in 10 years. Go live your dreams. And here's Kirby Saxton.
Hello, everyone. Thank you. It's an honor to be speaking to you today. I'd first like to thank Will McAllister for his lovely introduction and for everything that he's done for me. Some of you in the room might know this, but he's the real reason that I'm up here right now. So another round of applause for Will. Next, I'd love to thank Katrina and Nolan and the rest of the staff and faculty for having me today. They always have just been doing a great job. It's amazing how well the school's carried on all these years. I have to be honest, I always thought that I would end up speaking at one of these. I just thought they'd wait until I got super successful. But now is a good time, too. I think that they wanted to get me while they could afford me, which is great. Of course, I'd also like to thank and congratulate the graduating class of 2023. When they asked me to speak, they told me that they'd like me to talk a little bit about pursuing your dreams after high school, because I guess I've done a decent job at that. So I suppose I know a bit about it. I don't aim to undermine the accomplishment that you have all achieved today. Far from it. I think what you kids have done specifically cannot be overstated. When I went to high school, there was not a global pandemic. And so I don't know what that's like. It brought the world to a stop, but it didn't stop any of you, which is amazing. That's how I know that each of you has what it takes to pursue your goals and your dreams after you walk out of here today. I'm not here to tell you that it's easy, though. No. The choice to pursue my dreams specifically has led me to an unorthodox and often difficult path. But there are a few things that have helped me stay on the path, and I've put together a short list of tips. Originally, it was 5, but the speech went a little long, so you only get 3. You'll have to wait for my memoirs to read the other 2. So hopefully these are of some usefulness to you. My 3 keys for pursuing your dreams are as follows. 1, find your support. 2, seek out mentors. 3, sustain your motivation. I'll go through these a bit more. I'm extremely lucky. I have a family that is supportive of what I'm trying to do. Ever since I told them that I want to make movies, They have found a way to support me. I know how rare that is, but finding your support doesn't mean necessarily finding it in your family. A lot of the time, your support can come from your friends, your community, your significant other, or sometimes your former teachers, your East Hollywood classmates. Stick with the people that want to see you happy and want to see you succeed, because that's going to take you far. Those people are out there, and sometimes you just have to find them. It takes a little bit of time. Number two, seek out mentors. A lot of the time in life, I've found that people are afraid to reach out to other people, especially older people that seem to know what's going on in life when we're confused. I would highly encourage you to put the fear aside as much as you can in life. Take advantage of the knowledge and experience that older people have. Sometimes you learn a lesson from them that would have taken years for you to learn on your own. Having a mentor is kind of like having a human cheat code. You get to pick up all the knowledge morsels without any of the associated pain. My third tip is to sustain your motivation. It's certainly easier said than done, but one of the most important parts of pursuing any goal. Another way to put this would be don't give up. It's easy to have a dream. It's a lot harder to stick with it. My feature film 801, which Will so kindly mentioned and plugged, it took 2 years to make. A year and a half into filming it, the producer of the film and I we broke up. And I'm not proud to say that finishing the film was so hard that I wanted to give up. I really wanted to give up. But I kept going back and reminding myself why I started it all in the first place. Sometimes that means going back to your Toy Story 2. And I pushed myself through it. I found a way to sustain the motivation. And if you can find a way to stay as motivated to finish in the middle and the end of the project as you were at the beginning, you'll go far in life. And again, there's much more I could say about pursuing your dreams. I'll just throw out there, patience is so important. The last thing I want to say is that no matter what you pursue after high school, whether it be a higher education and a filmmaking career, which is my path, or something entirely different, life is it's a long game. It's not all going to come at once, but that's a good thing. If you have patience, you'll be able to appreciate the journey there. Thank you again, and congratulations to the East Hollywood High School graduating class of 2023. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Well, graduates, that long-awaited, he's taller than me, that long-awaited moment has arrived. Following the presentation and acceptance of the graduates, Haley Louiseau will read the names of the graduates and their plans for the future as they come forward to receive their diplomas. Please hold your applause until after she has read both the graduates' name and their future plans. East Hollywood High School, class of 2023, please rise. Skip Francone, representing the Board of Trustees, I present to you the candidates for graduation who have met all the requirements for high school graduation set forth by East Hollywood High School and the Utah State Board of Education. It is my pleasure, upon recommendation of the faculty, staff, and administration, to recommend that these students be awarded a high school diploma from East Hollywood High School.
On behalf of my associates on the East Hollywood High School Board of Trustees, we hereby accept the recommendation of Directors Katrina Walker and Ryan Marchant and the East Hollywood High School faculty. And by the virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Trustees, we confer upon each student so recommended a diploma of graduation from East Hollywood High School with all the rights, privileges, responsibilities, and recognition associated therewith.
Congratulations, East Hollywood High School graduates of 2023. Graduating students, I invite you to come forward to present yourselves to receive your diplomas. Attending Salt Lake Community College in 2024, studying elementary education with Walter the Sloth by their side. Faith Luna, planning to pursue music and photography. Jenica Jones, planning to pursue acting and filmmaking and attending Salt Lake Community College in the fall. Jonathan Adam Morales Reboledo, entering the workforce. Kylie Ackman, entering the workforce. Sean Ty Eichne, planning to become an engineer. Sam Eric, planning to join the Peace Corps and attend film school. Katie Baxter, unsure of what to do, but is looking forward to what's next in life. Robert Dylan Behunin, entering the workforce. Chloe Alyssa Boss, attending Salt Lake Community College in the fall with plans to attend medical school and become a nurse or doctor. Tori Ray Cabillas, planning to become a flight attendant to fly far, far away from here. Jeremiah Chan, entering the workforce at Napa Auto Parts. Zan Chandler, planning for world domination. Courtney Cleveland, planning to become a cosmetologist. Deja Marie Cloward, planning to explore her interests and find a dream job. Aiden Canole, entering the workforce. Tatiana Cruz, entering the workforce. Will Cullimore, entering the workforce. Zeke DeBrum, entering the workforce. Shyla DeGraff, planning to join the Peace Corps. Jay Dunn, planning to become a nurse. Kesley Earle, planning to become an artist. Peter Edwin, planning to venture out of the country. Cyan Fenton, planning to become an author. Robert Flores Castagno,
planning to go to trade school for plumbing. Blake Izzy Garner, planning to become a content creator like all the people they've looked up to for the years. And if that doesn't work out, hopefully they can pursue their dreams of art. Stacy Golsan, planning to become a tattoo artist and travel the world. Paige Grant, currently attending Davis Technical College. Jaden Harmon, attending Salt Lake Community College in the fall. Miles Emmett Hayes, planning on going to seek a grant, perhaps. Tristan Hendrickson, planning to enter the field of music engineering to pour his heart and soul into music. In the meantime, will be entering the workforce at Hot Topic. Kiki Marie Hernandez-Revega, planning to explore the world and the people in it. Finley Hodges, planning on traveling to Norway and visit most of Europe. Carly Isom, planning to become a world traveler. Milo Malaya Jacobson, planning on going to college and entering the mental health field. Cameron Jensen, entering the workforce. Connor Jensen, planning to become a music producer. Scarlett Jones, planning to travel and pursue art. Sky Kramer, attending Salt Lake Community College in the fall, studying business. Finn LaRose, attending Full Sail University in the fall, studying filmmaking and computer design. Aubrey Laea, entering the workforce. Declan Evergreen, planning to become a tattoo artist and body piercer. Elijah Lincoln, entering the workforce with plans to ascend Salt Lake Community College and become a mechanical engineer. Elena Liv, planning to work till she's able to move out of her mom's house. Alexis Lowenstein, planning not to lose everything. Cece Lopez, planning to save up to travel for a few years. Fernando Lopez, attending Salt Lake Community College in the fall and planning on becoming a plumber. Taylor Marshall, attending Salt Lake Community College to study fine arts after traveling the world, then planning to become a tattoo artist. Matthew Martinez, planning to attend trade school. Priscilla Mascarenas, planning to continue to work for the things she wants. Aime McMichael, entering the workforce. Quentin Moore, planning on attending college in the fall. Elise Ellen Robison, attending Salt Lake Community College in the fall, studying culinary arts. Kylie Robles, planning on studying music and becoming a musician. Nicole Thompson, planning to fight capitalism. Lucius Myers, planning to get further into filming. Bree Nebaker, entering the workforce and planning to become a high school teacher. Ruktok Santina Nebo, planning to go to BYU, Hawaii, or Idaho to study nursing. Faith Nilsson, planning to become an interior designer. Zevin Nuttle, attending Westminster in the fall, studying sociology and film. Fuliaki Ofa, entering the workforce. Renisha Zell Oleitamin, planning to save dogs. Jade Olson, hopes to retire by the time she's 30. Athena Owen, planning to attend college studying art and become a special effects makeup artist. Shay Pace, plans to study agriculture and botany. Liz Palmer, planning to take time for herself with plans to work as a forensic psychologist. Enta J. Peter, attending Salt Lake Community College. Maddie Raleigh, entering the workforce. Ashley Torres, planning to attend Salt Lake Community College in the fall, studying psychology. Ariana Trujillo, planning to design clothes and create her own clothing brand. Judah Tuyasoa, planning to enter the music industry or become a digital art creator. Tamara Rockwell, planning to attend Salt Lake Community College next spring. Caden Sees, planning to attend Salt Lake Community College. Sierra Autumn Smith, entering the workforce. Madison Steele, planning to attend Utah State University in the fall, studying history. Joseph E. Velasquez, planning to become a veterinarian. DeMarco Voorhees, planning on getting money and staying out of the way. Noah Walden, planning to move to Oregon and become a musician. Bailey S. Watson, planning to travel the world and experience different cultures and perspectives and then possibly becoming a history teacher. Syra Guerrero, entering the workforce. Eileen Bunkay and Gian Miller, entering the workforce. Angelina Quintero Alves, entering the workforce. Idana Halilovic, attending Salt Lake Community College in the spring. Congratulations to the class of 2023.
What is your name and age?
My name is Stacy. I'm 17 years old.
My name is Faye, and I'm 18 years old.
I'm Shyla. I'm 18.
My name is Keith, and I'm 17.
I'm Declan Evergreen. I changed my name. That's cool. The yearbook is different. I'm 18 now.
My name is Scar, and I'm 18 years old.
My name is Jade Olson. I'm 17.
My name is Tori Ray Cabillas, and I am 18.
My name is Peter Edwin. I'm 18.
My name is Enta Peter, and I'm 18 years old.
I'm Foley, and I'm 17.
I am Ashley, and I'm 18.
My name is Blake Garner, and I am 18.
My name is Elena, and I'm 18.
My name is Connor, and I'm 17.
I'm Carly, and I'm 18.
My name is Ash Robles, and I am 18 years old.
My name is Elijah, and I'm 18.
My name is Elise Robson, and I'm 18.
My name is Athena Owen, and I'm 16 years old.
My name is Jenica Jones, and I am 18.
Finley Hodges, I'm 17.
My name is Aiden Marino, and I'm 17.
I'm Cameron, and I'm 18.
How would you describe your East Hollywood High School experience?
You know, average.
Fun.
It was definitely a positive experience.
It was actually really welcoming. Like, I really like the layout of the school specifically. I really like the people, so yeah, it's been really nice.
Possibly the most funnest high school experience I ever had.
It was wild.
Just nothing like public high school.
Definitely, unique.
Fluctuating. It had its ups, it had its downs, but still happy.
To be honest, it changed a lot more when I was in public school. During freshman and sophomore, it hit me so hard. Since I came to East Hollywood, it changed a lot for me, everyone here. Like, how nice they are, how they care about you, and everyone treat each other equally. Doesn't matter your race, how the way you look, and all that, like, everyone was treated equally, and I loved that the most.
East Hollywood was just a really good place. It was a school that picked me up from a place where I was just anxious and sad, and I didn't feel accepted or, like, really belonging. And it kind of showed me that there was a different place for me and that I could be accepted somewhere.
Life-changing and a roller coaster.
Been roller coaster.
Very fun. They've like helped me through a lot. I started with like barely any credits, and now I'm like super close to graduating. Within like, you know, it all happened within a year.
It was pretty good. The teachers were really helpful and really kind. Definitely helped me get through.
Just hang out with the boys and then the teachers too. Mm-hmm. To make you feel welcome.
Welcoming, yeah.
In East Hollywood, you can be yourself.
It was eventful, and in a good way. Very, like, chaotic, and I feel like definitely by, like, my senior year, I was, like, doing it the most. So, when I, like, joined student government, and I met a bunch of other people, like, I met, like, a bunch of really cool juniors that, you know, I'm gonna miss them, you know, I'm not gonna see them anymore.
You're gonna make me cry! You make me cry!
What was your favorite part about this school?
Art. Probably art. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
It's either the art class or history of aviation, because I just love aviation.
Before coming to East, it was art, but now it's film, probably.
Film. Film was my favorite subject. I love the teachers and friends and just getting to be a part of a lot of projects.
Probably like Hive class.
Probably horror production. It was really fun. Make spooky films.
I'd say I really do like the teachers and the classes that are offered here.
What I'd probably remember most is the teachers.
Probably acting, if acting's a subject.
Either film or history.
Definitely history or film.
History.
History.
Probably history.
Maybe just gym class, like, with Taylor, yeah.
My favorite subject is Annie. I like her classes a lot.
Probably Annie's adult roles. I feel like I learned how to become, like, a better adult in the world, so.
I loved Annie's classes, all of the relationship, interpersonal relationship type classes. Those classes all made a very, very deep impact on me, and I still like use what I learned in them all the time.
I say math. Carl, I love math.
I like English, but
definitely the music, for sure.
I like music.
Science.
Oh, science. I love science.
It was just everything here is I loved.
What was a core memory you've had here?
When I ran into the locker. I wasn't paying attention.
I almost tripped down the stairs.
Probably basketball.
Playing basketball with the guys.
Making Graduation Sucks, the film. I loved it. It was awesome. It was just a group of people, and I got to fulfill my dreams of just being in a movie for the first time. It was just awesome, life-changing.
Making a lot of more friends that are actually like me.
My favorite memory is probably when I met my best friend, Sam.
Meeting my friends and, like, making the advanced film this year with them and working on that. The teachers that are cool, like, just like Thomas in general and Pete. Love him to death. I love film, but like Gibson's class last year where we just like watched movies and like talked and like read stuff, it was like one of my favorite classes that I've ever taken.
I made friends like with freshmen during my junior year, and I kind of felt like a mother to them. Specifically, it was helping them grow, even if they didn't realize it. It was really nice.
Probably when we went to the Huggle Zoo for Jordan's class.
Thomas's class. That's just like the core of the classes in East. It's just Thomas's history class and just how fun it is.
When we went to go make cat houses at Best Friends Animal Shelter, and then we went to Cold Stone after, and all of us were lactose intolerant in a van. Meeting my best friend and concert production of 2023, both of those things, just like, they really stick in my mind.
Back in freshman year, when me and all my friends, we threw like water balloons at each other.
Taylor had told me the ball will stay on the ground because I've had 4 concussions and he didn't want balls flying at me, you know. Yeah, well, the ball hit me in the head and I was the only one to get hit in the head. Taylor was right next to me and I was like, uh-huh. Yeah, I won't get hit in the head, sure. Yeah.
A really stressful day at home and I like, you know, came in to PM school and everything, and then Nicole just knew something was wrong and we just sit and talked for a while and she hugged me and she was just like a really big support to me.
The stairs with the boys after school. Every day we just hang out, sing.
I guess homecoming. Homecoming was really fun.
One time Cohen threw a hot sauce packet at me, which is pretty nice.
Would you say that graduation sucks?
Yeah, a little. But now that I'm here, I'm like ready. I don't know, I'll probably change my mind on graduation day.
Do you have any last words?
Again, enjoy your high school years, but also don't think too hard about it, if that makes sense, because everyone thinks, I want to get out of school, get this job, get this, and it's just like the straight path when it just, life doesn't always go that way, especially in this school.
Do activities, do what you love to do. Don't just waste your time.
Don't give up. Try your best.
If you give the school love, the school will love you.
Be swag.
Be kind.
For anybody that thinks they can't graduate, you absolutely can, because literally, like I said, I started out with nothing and now they've walked me through every step of the way and they've helped me so much and, you know, everybody can do it.
I guess just to say how grateful I am for all the adults who work here and help you to like become the best adult you can be before you leave.
People are going to be judgy no matter what. That's just how life is. So just be yourself. Don't be scared of, you know, expressing who you are. I was like that for the longest time and this school gave me the opportunity to find out who I was and it was really nice.
Don't focus on drama. Just don't do it. Like, you're all like the same age. You're all children. Like, there's no use creating drama, making drama, or even being involved in it.
it's just not worth it for you, it's not worth it for them. Once you move it, once you leave high school, none of it matters.
Just live in your own world. Don't pay attention to anyone else or what they're thinking. Just do what you want to do.
Just don't care what anybody here says at all, ever, because most of the time people suck, even people that you like. So, yeah.
I know it sounds like really corny, but be yourself. I know that might seem hard, but in this place you can open up. And for the people who do not like you for you, that's on them, I guess.
To like the next kids who come, be yourself, be unique, and remember high school does not last forever.
Make friends everywhere, because like anyone could be your friend, and be nice to everyone, and just come here all the time with a positive attitude, and you know, while it lasts.
Be nice to people, and enjoy high school, and don't get caught up in all the shit that's not even gonna matter when you're gone. Please, for the love of God.
To be positive, and no matter what, keep your head up.
It's okay.
It's okay.
Thank you guys for watching my channel, and make sure to like and subscribe. Tweet me at David Dobrik.
Bye, East Hollywood. Goodbye forever.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Goodbye.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East.
Goodbye, East Hollywood. Good luck.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, members.
Bye, girls.
Adios.
Peace.
Bye, East Hollywood. Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, East Hollywood.
Bye, guys.
Bye, girls.
Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, East Hollywood. Bye, East Hollywood.
Bye, members.
Bye, East Hollywood.
All right. Graduates, will you please stand? Well, that's it. It's official. Please move your tassel from the right side of your cap to the left, signifying that you are a high school graduate. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2023 graduating class of East Hollywood High School. You may throw your caps. Graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it is a long-standing tradition at East Hollywood High School graduation for the graduates to exit to a surprise recessional march that is fitting for a film school. Our graduates will be marching out tonight to I Ain't Worried About It from the film Maverick, Top Gun. Please remain seated until the graduates have marched out of the auditorium. Thank you, graduates. That's a wrap for the class of 2023.